Welcome to this short explanation of the track Building Engineering within the Master of Science Civil Engineering at TU Delft. In this video, we will present to you the following topics: some general information on what is building engineering, the courses that we will offer during the two-year track, the two specializations that we offer, some highlights, and an important part of your track, the master thesis research. And finally, of course, you might be interested to learn about job perspectives. Buildings have always been an important part of human society. From the moment that humans changed their lifestyle from nomadic into settling, buildings have become a necessity that has been growing in complexity ever since. Where the first human beings only needed a roof over their head and relied on farm animals and fire to keep them warm, the art of construction has developed to an impressive level over the centuries, as clearly demonstrated by this old cathedral in Delft. In modern buildings, humans require light, space, and climate control. Furthermore, modern man requires a greater variety of buildings, from churches to football temples, from offices to train stations, and so on. Buildings with ever-increasing complexity and ever-increasing scale. The Master of Science track Building Engineering offers you a varied and broad program that deals with every aspect of building engineering over the lifespan of a building. As a civil engineer, you need a broad range of knowledge in order to be able to make a valuable contribution to the design and construction of building structures. And that is why this track covers the whole building process from the planning phase up to the realization and construction of the building. We also consider the options for the reuse of buildings. Sustainability is inextricably linked to the construction and the times in which we live. Because the aesthetic aspects of buildings are becoming more and more important too, due to their visual impact on our habitat, architectural design is becoming increasingly important. But a beautiful building still needs a sound structure. You can choose between two specializations. Both start with some common courses. In first place, architectural history. In this course, you will learn about architectural styles and existing buildings. Then forms of collaboration. It's about how to work effectively with large numbers of other actors, from client to contractor, other engineers and end users of your building. Forensic structural engineering is about why sometimes buildings fall down and how to learn from these occasions for the future. Parametric design and engineering is about mastering complexity in geometry and optimization for particular design objectives. Then introduction into building physics and facades. A building, as you know, is more than just a structure. The facade and interior climate are at least as important. Then all civil engineers have an ethics course, how to act in an ethical manner as a civil engineer in complex questions. And finally, the master thesis. All civil engineer students finalize their studies with a 9-month thesis research. More about that later on. After completing your common courses, you will focus on one of the two specializations, structural design or building technology and physics. The structural design specialization starts with mechanics courses, dynamics courses. Some are compulsory, others are elective. For all construction materials, you will need to follow at least one course: steel, concrete, timber, glass, and as electives, fiber reinforced plastics, and also 3D printed materials. Then we advise you to do courses on soil and foundations, for every structure needs a foundation. Nowadays, there's much more emphasis on sustainability of building materials and also of durability. Then many of the courses that we do are design oriented, so you do not only learn to make calculations, but you really start to make a design from scratch. And some students also take experimental work in the program, usually in the master thesis, because that's the point where this is best feasible. Then the building technology and physics part, specialization, we there focus on facade technology, facade design, and all the laws of building physics, focusing on heat, energy, daylight and sunlight, acoustics, wind. Usually this specialization does a lot with simulation models, so trying to simulate the interior climate of a building, for example, or trying to simulate the daylight. But also various students have done experimental work, for example, measuring temperatures or daylight or sunlight, wind speeds. So that is what you can do in this specialization. MEGA is a course that already runs for over 25 years. And during this multidisciplinary design course, tutors from industry and university will support you during the development of a design of a high-rise building, which is based on a realistic program and a realistic construction spot. This course is organized by the Faculty of Architecture in close cooperation with civil engineering. And over the past years, many architects and structural engineers from famous tall buildings around the world have visited this workshop as guest speakers and tutors. And they provided feedback to the groups of students and often expressed their admiration for the high level of realism that was shown in the designs. The course Parametric Design and Engineering teaches you how to deal with complex parametric geometry descriptions in 3D CAD, and also offers you methods to optimize and analyze your design for various performance objectives. A final highlight that I'd like to mention is the course Forensic Structural Engineering. This course teaches you how to learn from failures and systematically investigate the causes of these failures using a forensic method developed in Delft. The course is taught by people that have been involved as investigators in various serious collapse cases in the Netherlands and international. Then an important part which finalizes your 2-year Master of Science study in Delft is your master thesis research. Roughly 1/3 of the students does a master thesis at a company. Another 1/3 finds a topic from TU Delft researchers. And 1/3 of the students roughly is coming with a topic him or herself. Let me just give you an example of each category. First, the example, some examples of topics with companies. Pascal Martens did an optimization of 3D printed concrete at the company White Lioness. Bram Hecker, he did a facade element design in 3D concrete printing for the two companies Movares and Bruil. Feng Yao Zhang, she did a research topic for TNO, which is a research institute in the Netherlands, studying the acoustic emission of concrete while cracking. Then some topics from the university. Structural assessment of a calcium silicate element masonry assemblage. This was a study from Oana Damian. She studied a large lab setup that we had in Delft a few years ago, and she dedicated her master thesis to analyzing the results. This was a topic of Greek student Andreas Kilimatos, who studied tensile stresses in shell structure. Michou Mureau, a Dutch student who investigated a new material, thin glass, which is also used in mobile phones and tablets, how this could be used in buildings. Some topics from that students came with themselves. Noor Debet, she graduated on daylight in buildings and the experience of that daylight by users of the building. Charlotte Roger, she investigated self-healing concrete in a designed a bridge that she designed together with investigators of TU Delft. Then finally, the job perspective of the track Building Engineering. Generally, our students do not have much difficulty finding employment. You see a number of companies here. What companies appreciate in our students is their combination of usually a very good Bachelor of Science in the Netherlands or abroad, and on top of that, the Master of Science Building Engineering, which has both fundamental parts in it, like mechanics, dynamics, but also the different building materials that are used: concrete, steel, timber, glass. And finally, our students also are skilled in designing. So many of our courses already have an exercise in which a design is made. And that's, of course, a skill that is appreciated very much by companies that have to do design as their daily business. So hopefully you found this an instructive video. If you need more information, please contact the master coordinator of the track Building Engineering. Have a nice day.